CBS News Miami.
Good afternoon, and thank you for joining us. I'm Naja Sherman, and welcome to CBS News Miami's 4 p.m. Quickcast. Let's take a look at today's top stories. We have breaking news off the top. Dangerous moments in Deerfield Beach. Chopper 4 over the scene along Northwest 1st Terrace and 7th Court. BSO deputies say a 6-year-old was rushed to the hospital. He had a full hand amputation. Authorities say it happened after a firework exploded. No word yet on the condition of the child. CBS News Miami's Ted Scouten is at the scene. He'll have a full report tonight at 5. The director of the Secret Service has resigned. It's following the attempted assassination of former President Donald Trump. Kimberly Cheadle is stepping down one day after she was grilled on Capitol Hill. During the hearing, Cheadle said she took full responsibility for any security lapse on the day of the shooting. Moments ago, we got this reaction from the Speaker of the House.
And the immediate reaction to her resignation is that it is overdue. She should have done this at least a week ago. I'm happy to see that. I'm happy to see that she has heeded the call of both Republicans and Democrats. Now we have to pick up the pieces. We have to rebuild the American people's faith and trust in the Secret Service as an agency.
Cheadle had been the Secret Service director since August of 2022.
Always alerting, always tracking. This is Next Weather.
And taking a live look outside, a beautiful day, mainly dry here in South Florida. Next Weather meteorologist Cindy Pressler lets us know what's ahead.
Yeah, no rain here today. Kind of a dry situation. We've got some dust aloft, and our temperatures are hot, though, but there is some low-level moisture, so look at Key West. Feels like it's at 106 degrees right now. I saw 107 this last hour, so we just are not getting the rain here, but there are some spotty thunderstorms, mainly to the north and the west, and I'll show you that in a bit. This is what is next. Interior and Gulf storms, really not expecting anything here. And I think that's going to continue for the next 3 days. So a lot of dry time here. Drier pattern. Hot and breezy days until we get to the weekend, I think, and then we'll start to see a better chance with some showers and thunderstorms. At this point, we've had quite a bit of rain out here in Collier County, moving into Lee County, Monroe County, picking up some thunderstorms as well, and just some spotty storms here in the western part of Broward County. That's where they've been this afternoon, but nothing really to speak of here in the metro area. One little shower just slipped right to the north of Fort Lauderdale. Now it's up here in the border, just passing through 27 at this point. So that's about it today. These little showers, they're going to continue to make their way off to the north and west, so we're probably not going to see a whole lot here. You might find a spot shower later on this evening, but other than that, that's about it. Some showers also along 41, and these are all making their way to the west. This is what that strong easterly flow will do, and we have Saharan dust that's sitting at the mid-levels at this point, and that tends to squelch showers and thunderstorms, but I think it's more of the easterly flow. That dust is coming back again by the time we get into the weekend and next week, but overall, thins out a little bit, but it does not leave us completely. So the dust is there to stay for a while. Showers and storms this afternoon, again, all to the west. Don't see a whole lot here in the east side. One little shower here and there, and that's about it. So our rain chances will be very low Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, even Saturday. I think by Sunday into Monday, we're going to up the rain chances just slightly. We'll have to see how that goes, because so far we just have not had a lot of rain. July has been very dry here for the Miami and Fort Lauderdale areas. And little showers here and there, nothing really to speak of. Everything gets pushed off to the west. That's because of our strong east-southeasterly flow, so that's going to be the case for the rest of the week. Here's your forecast. Temperature is still topping out around 92 degrees. That'll be the case Wednesday and Thursday. Then you get into a little bit better rain chances. I think our best rain chance for the next 7 pops in on Monday.
Vice President Kamala Harris hits the campaign trail today for the first time as the 2024 presidential candidate. She's visiting the battleground state of Wisconsin. All this while President Biden is heading back to D.C. for the first time since his recent battle with COVID. CBS News Miami's Skylar Henry joins us live from Washington, D.C. with the latest. Skylar.
Hey, Naja, good to be with you. Yeah, a lot of momentum surrounding the vice president and her campaign. Just in the last 5 minutes, the campaign sent this out saying that they have raised more than $100 million just between Sunday afternoon and Monday evening. Just goes to show the amount of real support and enthusiasm for her. Meanwhile, she had the opportunity today at the rally in Wisconsin to really make her case to the American people and say why she's the better option as opposed to former President Trump.
An enthusiastic Wisconsin crowd welcomed Vice President Kamala Harris for her first campaign rally as the likely Democratic nominee.
I pledge to you, I will spend the coming weeks continuing to unite our party so that we are ready to win in November.
Harris spoke with voters in Milwaukee, the site of last week's Republican National Convention, and made the case why they should choose her over former President Donald Trump.
In this campaign, I promise you, I will proudly put my record against his any day of the week.
President Biden said he made the decision to step aside because it was the right thing to do. He says he'll explain more when he addresses the nation Wednesday night.
Mr. President, what will your message be tomorrow night?
Biden returned to the White House Tuesday afternoon for the first time since his COVID infection last week. Democrats at what has become Harris's largest campaign event to date are reflecting on the change.
Seeing Biden step down from the top of the ticket, I felt so hopeless. And I woke up the next morning and was like, this is something I can do to put real action to power. And I gave my first campaign donation to Vice President Harris's campaign.
Nearly 40% of Democrats surveyed in a new CBS News poll say they're now more motivated to vote in November.
Why is that important? Because Democrats have lagged Republicans so far in saying that they're going to turn out, and turnout could be the determining factor in November.
83% of Democrats surveyed say Biden made the right choice in stepping aside as the nominee.
And the other thing to point out here, Naja, is that the vice president still needs to figure out who she is going to pick as her running mate. We learned that former Attorney General Eric Holder has been put in charge of that process to vet potential candidates. We've seen the short list of potential names that are out there. We'll ultimately see who she will decide. We're here at the White House. I'm Skylar Henry. Back to you.
Every day, another interesting development, that's for sure. Skylar, thank you for that live report. A SWAT standoff overnight in a southwest Miami-Dade neighborhood. CBS News Miami's Yvonne Taylor is at the scene with the latest.
Yes, this is the house that was raided by FBI and Miami-Dade police officers. Now, Miami-Dade police public information officer tells me that what they were doing is executing a, quote, narcotics warrant and more, end quote. That is the only thing that they're saying so far. But let's get you to some video that one of the neighbors took early in the morning, and you can actually hear the sirens and more.
What the f*** is going on at 6 o'clock in the morning in my house?
Residents describe what they saw and heard in the area of Southwest 127th Avenue and 120th Street at approximately 6 a.m. Some of them abruptly got out of their beds because of the commotion. Now, in the early mornings, you could see some undercover agents and police officers coming in and out of the house, a few of them carrying boxes. Michael Pascual was one of the neighbors who witnessed what happened close to his house.
You see the FBI just throwing flashbangs. Started at 6 a.m. in the morning. I heard the first flashbang. They went inside to take people out, the whole family out. They've been renting here already for 2 years already. We've been knowing them. They come outside and they wait. We just wave at them, but everybody here is just like, you know, on their own business. We don't ask anything.
Now, we've gotten information by the FBI, and they're telling us that their agents were conducting a court ordered activity without revealing any additional details. Apparently, two people were handcuffed. They left the house early this morning. They have not been identified, and that is the only information that FBI as well as police are revealing right now. This is all we have so far. We are in Southwest Miami-Dade. Ivan Taylor, CBS News, Miami.
Lobster mini season will get underway in less than 12 hours. When we come back, what you need to know to stay safe and follow the rules on the water. Welcome back to CBS News Miami's 4 p.m. Quickcast. New details in a Homestead police investigation. Police now tell us that a man was shot at the Park Motel. It's located along South Chrome Avenue and Southwest 6th Street. The man was airlifted to Jackson South. No word on his condition or what led to the shooting. New information in the deadly shooting of a toddler. It happened at a birthday party in Fort Lauderdale Sunday. Police say they have found at least one of the cars involved in the shooting. 3-year-old Rilo Yancey was shot while celebrating at Riverland Park. Fire rescue rushed him to the hospital, but sadly he did not make it. Detectives urge anyone with information to call the Broward Crime Stoppers. The number is 954-493-TIPS. CBS News Miami's Peter Dench spoke with the great-grandfather of the child, and that report is coming up at 5. 4 days after that global computer outage that caused chaos around the world, some airline passengers are still stranded. CBS News Miami's Chris Van Cleve is at LA International Airport with the latest.
Eric Daniels thought he and his wife were finally going back home to Houston. They've been stuck in LA since Friday because of Delta's IT meltdown. When we met him last night, he just learned his fourth flight to Texas had been canceled.
How frustrated are you?
This is crazy.
Since the CrowdStrike software outage began Friday morning, Delta has canceled over 5,300 flights and hundreds more on its regional partners, stranding people across the country and around the world.
Reliable is not spelled D-E-L-T-A.
Airline analyst Henry Hartevelt.
Delta likes to invest in things it can show off. You don't show off crew scheduling systems. You don't show off network operating centers. Unfortunately, Delta's failure to invest in key technology systems has bitten the airline on the behind, and its customers and employees are paying a price.
Delta CEO is apologizing to customers. The airline says it's making refunds available and reimbursing eligible expenses like food and hotel accommodations. Delta says one of its critical systems tracking where its crews are is still not fully operational days after the outage, and that's forced their delays and cancellations to snowball.
I think I've passed exhaustion and frustration, and now I'm just
ready to go home.
If you're stuck in this, your options aren't great. You can bear with Delta as they reset the operation, or you can choose to cancel your remaining flight. You'll get a refund for that, but you'll just have to book on another airline. Don't expect Delta to pay the difference. The airline will reimburse for certain expenses like hotels, food, transportation to and from the airport. So save those receipts. You'll be able to submit them online, but those refunds will likely take a few weeks as the focus right now is getting the operation back running. Chris Van Cleve, CBS News, Los Angeles.
The countdown is on to mini lobster season here in Florida. The season begins at midnight. Florida Fish and Wildlife say to measure your lobsters before bringing them on board. FWC also says that bringing a lobster that's too small or too many of them home with you is a crime. Lobster mini season starts July 24th and 25th. The regular season starts in about 2 weeks. That's the CBS News Miami Quickcast. I'm Nasha Sherman. Stay tuned for more news right here on CBS News Miami and have a fantastic day.